money, money haters, one bad mind. God knows I'm me, hands up from you. Now about stand. Well, I make me big up me friend them.
Mr. Vegas, before in your early years, you were singing with Mavado, with Vibes Cartel, and all those guys. Now, how do your peers see you now? Now that you're singing for the Lord, the King of Glory, how do they view you as a person? Is it just a lifestyle, or is it just for show?
You know, at the end of the day, you know, you can always put on the shows that you want to put on, but it is what is in your heart
True. That
God is working with. You understand? So I can always go out there and sing a million gospel songs and tell you here that, oh, I'm not going to sing another reggae song when reggae is a part of my culture. You know, I embrace clean, positive reggae music. Yeah. I embrace clean, positive dancehall music because that is a part of my culture. Okay. That is, you know, my habitation is Jamaica. Yes. I didn't grow up in a country of rock and roll. If I did grow up in a country where they play rock and roll, I would be singing rock and roll. And nobody right. would not have a problem with it. If I grew up
That's
in
true.
Puerto Rico, I would be singing Spanish. Yeah. And you would know what I am singing in Spanish because you speak English. Okay. You know, so you know, reggae is a part of my culture.
Mr. Vegas, I know that you were at the Jamrock. Cruise, yes sir, Jama Cruise, yes sir.
Yes sir.
And you were singing not Christian music, but you're singing secular music. Now, do you intend to keep singing those music, or do you plan to just stop singing that?
First and foremost, we have to understand that this walk is one day at a time. You understand? And we have to understand that people talk about Jama Cruise, and you know there was, I think there were a few Christian people who had a problem with some songs. You understand? Without even knowing the situation of Jamra Cruz, and a situation which I am proud of. Because I was booked for that show maybe over a year before, you know, I continued my spiritual walk.
Yes.
You understand? Because sometimes it's just a spiritual cleansing. You want a spiritual cleansing. You want to, you know, you want to draw closer to God.
Correct.
You know, so when I did Jamra Cruz, basically I was booked for that show how many months before?
Wow.
You know, but for me, the experience was one of the best experience,
yes.
Because I was able to share the gospel as well.
Wow.
And I think in our community, in our gospel community in the West Indies, people put more emphasis on artists, like, oh, an artist wanna walk with Christ. And the first thing we start ask, so you're gonna stop singing your songs?
Wow.
But we don't say that to the policeman. Are you gonna stop being a policeman? Are you going to stop being a soldier?
Definitely not.
Are you going to stop going to the job that you used to go to?
Correct.
Because your job is enough sinners there. The
wow.
boss that you're working for, maybe don't believe in God. You understand? But
I like
everything
what
is just one day at a time, brother.
I like what you're saying.
You plant corn yesterday and the corn beer.
Yes.
You reap the corn.
Very
you plant
good.
New corn. This corn start beer. Or you plant peas this time.
Yes.
And the peas beer, you just go and work with peas.
That's correct. That's
you can't just say, yo, me no want no corn and just kill
right.
the whole of the corn then where you plant.
Yes, and so life is actually a stage, you know, so, and no one's perfect, right? So
baby step, brother.
We're all moving together in one accord.
Gospel Faith TV, taking the gospel to the world.